Greetings and welcome back, one and all, to From the Depth and to the Vehicle Designer, where I am climbing to the very highest mountain I can find. Oh, well, actually, there are bound to be much higher ones over there. And despite the fact that there's a Vehicle Designer, Kuroro is over there because I use the Kuroro to fast travel from where it just spawns you out in the middle of the ocean to the nearest landmass by loading in the Kuroro and spawning in its seat when it loaded. A bit of pro tip there. Cheat hacks, if you will. We spawn somewhere out there. Now, the Kuroro will actually serve it to your purpose. The Kuroro can be there's no way for me to put this gently, Kuroro. You're going to be target practice. Now, target practice for what is what you may be asking yourselves. And the first point of order in this episode, I suppose, would be for me to reveal which weapon system has won the honor of being our first. Where are you? Wouldn't be our first major weapon system for the Doxa scene. Now, just to cover something that a couple of people seemed a bit confused about, this is not going to be the only weapon system that I use. It's going to be one of the weapon systems I use. I guess that confusion came down largely to my own poor attempt at explaining what I was going to do, and I do apologize for that. But yeah, so we're going to be building a single weapon system in this episode, but it is not going to be the only weapon system that we use for the Dark City. It is just going to be the first one that I designed, because it's going to take a little while. Now, I've waffled on enough about that. I'm sure you all want to know what is the weapon system that's going to be built. And I am maybe going to tell... Okay, I'll tell you. It is going to be the missile system. The large missile array got a total of 476 votes, whilst the coastal cannon came in at only 368. And yes, I did count all of the votes that were placed in the comments, but those who couldn't use the annotations. Unfortunately, had I put links in the video description, it wouldn't have actually helped, because the annotations are specifically measured by YouTube, so I've got them in my analytics which annotation was clicked, but if it was just a hyperlink, it wouldn't have been tracked in the same way. So unfortunately, there's no easy solution to that one, but perhaps in the next time I put a vote, I'll include a straw poll link, for example, so that those who use mobile devices can also take part. There we go. Wow, that's really, really loud. Wow. I may not have thought that through. Let's try this one. No, will you not? You suck. Okay, we'll do that one. I really wish this would mirror, but okay, let's do one more. Ah, craziness, sound everywhere. It hurts my brain. Though, not quite as badly as it hurts my brain to see that there are weird patterns on the floor. Really, game, do you do this on purpose? I think you might. But there we go. So we've got a structure now. The structure is incredibly important because we're going to be building these weapon systems on a structure, not too unlike this. Our structure will be much, much more awesome, of course. But there are a few things that have come to mind with the way that we're going to have to build this. Firstly, with a missile array, I'm going to have multiple different types of missiles. And probably what we're going to be doing is I'll build each structure, like each weapon system will be an individual structure, so we can have a local AI, up to four different targeting systems. Because if I have the entire Dock City as one enormous monolithic structure, then it's going to be limited to four different channels that AI can transmit on. And it's going to have many more guns than that, and many more guns that are going to want to look at different targets than that. So realistically, what I'm probably going to have is like each weapon turret is going to be an enormous structure in and of itself, with a central AI and central weapon system and all of that kind of stuff. And we'll just have to see how all of that goes together in the way that we're going to be putting this building the city up just out of many, many different structures rather than one large one the way I originally planned. But to start with, we are going to need a prefab. I think this is one of the better engines that I designed in my engine science video, so we'll use this one. Boom, there we go. So we've got some power on here now. We will also add, we don't need a fuel processor, I don't think, but we'll add in some fuel because our fuel is infinite. Well, actually, we will, I think, need a fuel processor, come to think of it.
So we will just add a fuel processor right there, just so it fills this thing up. Can I turn this on? Turned on. Good, good, good. The next thing we're going to need, we are going to need some ammo barrels for everything that we're going to be... Oh, have I turned off the mirror line? It appears that I have. Let's turn... Oh, well, no. Let's turn... Ah! Mirror line. Why are you acting up? It's one of the rare times where I remember you right from the beginning. And then you decide to just be all in my face. And in the wrong place, more to the point. Neither in my face, actually, or in the right place. So what I said was completely factually incorrect. But there we go. That's enough ammo for our tests. Right, okay. So the first thing we're going to want to do is build up a simple little system. Now, I've experimented a little bit with weapon systems, specifically with some of the parts of missiles that are interesting. And I have actually saved two designs, so rather than walk you through me making them all over. But we're going to build a new weapon system with a specific missile length. And the first system is going to be an AA system. Now, these are going to be dotted around the place, which would be quite nice. It is so unfortunate that you can't build an AI mainframe on a turret, because if you could, I'd make them completely self-contained. And it would be glorious in the way that only a self-contained anti-air missile system can be glorious. But for now, we're going to be making a bit of a platform just out of wood. Let's make it a 3x3. Is this even a 3x3? I really don't know. 1, 2, 3. There we go. And then exactly the same. 1, 2, 3. And then, ooh, why is everything moving the wrong way? Down one more. There we are. Perfect. And then once again. Wonderful. Right. Now, we just need to connect these in here. The reason why I made it 3x3 is so that there is a definite middle. And then that will be the point where we're going to build our first turret. So we want a new object. We want a 360 turret. We don't need it to be torqueless or anything like that, because this is a structure. It's not going to move around. We don't have to worry about recoil for the most part on anything. Right. Now, first starters we need to go on. We'll set this up as default system 5. Just so that the AA system, if I'm in the turret, I want number 5 to be further away from the hotkeys that I'm going to be going for. The like main weapon systems, I'd want to be 1, 2, and 3, the ones that I might want to control. 5 will be the furthest away from that. Now, we are going to want to build... Well, first and foremost, actually, we are going to want to make this metal, because this is going to be a prefab that we're going to take everywhere with us. And although it's going to be a prefab and not a structure itself, so it's not going to have a name and be loaded in the way that I would normally do things, I'll name the prefabs based on what chat would like. So, as always, do come up with ideas, post suggestions in the comments, and we'll see which one we end up with. But for now, we're just going to make a base. We're probably, in fact, almost certainly going to be getting rid of that base in time. In fact... probably going to get rid of it right now. Once I've built these up like so, we're going to put an AI down here. It is going to be an AI local weapon controller, and it is going to go right by there. And it's also going to be black, and it's going to be fine. How far out do we want to change this? Because the actual targeting priorities will be controlled by the AI that's controlling the anti-air turrets. But really, I want to restrict how far out it's going to fire to about, I would say, 1,000. I've not tested these missiles to find out if they can go that far. I'll have to adjust this as time goes on to find the correct balance for that. But then we take that away. Actually, no, we do want that still. Place that there for now. What I would like is... let's see. The forward point is this way. I want the missile controller above this. So we go with the missile controller. I also don't want it to be colored at all. I'll place it right there. We'll also set this up on 5 as well. So there we go. Now, this has very specific directions that it can look out to. It can connect at the front. It connects at the sides. Can't connect at the back or top or bottom, and that's fine. This weapon controller should be controlling basically the turret itself and the weapon system above it, which is perfect. Though that being said, it doesn't actually need to be able to control them. But I generally like it to have that sort of connection. We want to go back to the fleet main color. We also want the six-way connectors. We also want the mirror line in there. There we go. Now, what I'm thinking here is we're going to want this to be a designated target. We're going to want the missile system to be able to pick its own targets here. And designate them with a laser so that our weapon systems themselves, the actual missiles, don't have to worry too much about being full of guidance systems. So we'll have the launch pads on either side. We'll make this a quad turret, I think. So four different missiles launched at any air threats. At the very top, I want a black. Let's go back to fleet main. We're not going to need an identify friend or foe because it's going to be designated. So stagger fire add-on, I think, would be good. The reason why I think a staggered fire would be good is when you're tracking air targets, your missiles will tend to hit the tail end or the wings, because the air targets tend to be very, very fast. But the first one to hit it is going to slow the vehicle down. So then the other missiles that are following will have a better chance of actually hitting what they're aiming for, which will tend to be the AI, the ammo stockpile, the weapons. So if we stagger them, then the first one to hit might only hit the tail or the wing. The second might only do that as well. But by that point, the vehicle will be sufficiently slowed or sufficiently difficult to maneuver that the following missiles will be able to target and hit some important systems. Or at least that's what I'm going to hope will happen. Now, over here, we've got a fairly front-heavy system right now. And right at the top, we're going to want, laser emitter. We're going to color this one red, though, because it's part of the weapon system itself. And I do like having the weapon systems actually, the actual weapon parts red. I think that looks quite nice. We'll also grab the missile blocks. We're going to lock it in place and tilt it that way. We've got a nice four-long missile there. Nice four-long missile there. This is actually looking like a pretty good setup, honestly. I'm remarkably happy with what we've got. Now I would like to go back to blocks. We'll go metal blocks. I didn't actually need to do that. What I wanted to do was go for colors. I'm a derp. One there. There as well. And then we can... You know what? We can just tidy up the back a little bit if we want. We're not going to quite be able to tidy up the way I wanted to. Actually, no. Why not? The bottom of the AI weapon controller is going to be a bit of a pain. But, oh well. I'm sure we can live with that. Now go down there. Make that up. There we are. Now, they've done away with the left and right slopes because they're pretty much just reorientated regular slopes. So there we are. That's the back. Let's actually get these ones here. So one there. Then rotate this. There we go. And then we can have, you know, why not have the triangles like that? So there's a bit more of a spike. I actually really like that. Even though this is going to negatively impact on how far back this turret can tip, damn, is it going to look good? I refuse not to use this. Flat out refuse. There we go. There we are. So that's the rear. And we still got access to the AI control. So if we needed to change anything, I'm assuming we're not going to need to change anything. But you never can tell. Now we'll use the 4-meter slopes. We'll rotate it that way. So that's one. And then two. Then we just need the bottom one in place. And three. Four. Okay, so there we are. That is our AA turret. I think it looks kind of awesome. Now, as for the missiles, as I said, I've already gone to the effort of preparing some missiles. They're not particularly well written. We've got HE and EMP. Now, do I want the AA system to use EMP missiles or heavy explosive missiles? I will actually give these better names at some point. Let's load that in and have a look. This is the setup, and the difference between the two types of missiles is one has got two explosive warheads and one has got two EMP warheads. Short range thruster, two fuel tanks, two fins, EMP warheads, and a laser designator receiver. Now, the obvious and nice thing about the EMP is it damages electronics, takes out AIs, takes out shields. Shields aren't too much of a concern for missiles, but the AIs very much so. Because if we could just hit something with EMPs, wipe out its AI, then easy to capture. But if the AI is deeply concealed, then it's going to be harder to get to. Ooh, wait. You know what we could do? There's no rule that says I can't have two different types of weapons on this. Let's do that. Let's have... I'm not sure how effective this is going to make this design, but we'll have two heavy explosives, two EMP. I'm putting them top and bottom the way I have, in hopes that it launches one EMP first or one HE, and basically alternate. So heavy explosive EMP, heavy explosive EMP, or the other way around. And ideally, that should be quite a potent weapon. Now, I will be saving this as a prefab, but I'll probably be doing that off screen at the end, I imagine. But that is one weapon system all set to go. Let's just get up here. I can control it with this. I'm so sorry, Guerrero. I hope you can learn to forgive me. I wouldn't be surprised if you could not, though. But look, it's just too good of a target. Binos and Guerrero, thank you for your sacrifice. There we go. Ooh, you know what? I could put on some launchers as well. That was good. I think I may have just knocked out. In fact, that doesn't have AI yet because only the actual HMS Kuroro has AI. But okay, you know, that didn't do too badly. I'm not sure how far away that is. But there's one more thing we can add on this before we're done. And that is the eject add-ons. I would also like them to be colored red. It's not in the right position, unfortunately. Almost, though. There we go. So, 1, 2. We'll only have one on each one, just to give it a little bit more of an interesting look, really. We're not going to be putting them on the bottom, because then it would interfere with how this turret can tip back and forward. So, I'm pretty satisfied with that. Kuroro's already repairing itself, thankfully. Please don't aim at what we're already doing, because I imagine it's got its little repair drones out there, fixing things as it goes. Well done, Kuroro. Okay, right. Next system. We are going to want... There are effectively four weapon systems that I want to be part of the missile array. The AIA missiles, and I'll probably have multiples of those on the structure. There is also going to be the silos. I'll probably build those last. The next big system, and this is going to have two separate weapon systems working for it, is going to be a flare designator and a swarm missile system. Now, what I mean by flare designator is that there is now a sticky flare component that you can build on missiles. And rather than doing anything, as you might expect, with actually, you can use it exactly as you might expect as a sort of countermeasure to lure away infrared-guided missiles from your own structures. But you can also use it offensively. And, I guess it doesn't really matter, but it does to me. But you can use it also in a much more offensive capacity by having it act as a guidance point for your own infrared missiles. So you'd place it down and fire, it would be the first thing fired. Then you could have a swarm of unguided, relatively, just infrared seeker guided missiles chasing that sticky flare. So you'd the name implies, it will stick to structures. So, or vehicles for that matter. So you could launch the flare first, have it stick to something, and then follow that up with an enormous swarm of infrared guided rockets. And that is exactly what we're going to be doing. Right, there we go. And then we can just lay down a midline there. And then it doesn't really matter too much. We'll just place it there. Okay, so we want another object. New object, another turret, 360 turret. Now this one, I'm thinking might do better with a bit of a lift up, actually. I think we'll design this one to have a bit of a plinth to be built on from its main support structure so it can tip back and forward properly. So something like this. Obviously, what we build on the Dark City will be significantly more robust, but this will do for a platform to actually design this weapon system on. So there we go. This is our start. Now, unlike the other one, it's going to have a fairly substantial base. We want metal blocks, we want metal beams, we want the color picker to be black, and let's build this out. Now, depending on how long it takes me to do this, I might split up the construction of the missile system across two episodes. I'm not entirely sure of that yet, but it is a possibility. I don't want to take this out too far in that direction, so what we could do instead is something like this. Build that out by two, same there. Metal blocks then. There we go. And lock that in position. Just bring these out there. Now, how much is this? If we assume we're going to put a side on it, maybe even too thick perhaps, but we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Ooh. So we've got 15. This would have a row of 15 missiles on it. Now, these missiles are going to be smaller, much smaller than the previous ones. Let's lock that in position there. Then rotate. There we go. I'm thinking that these are just basically be swarm rockets. So you're going to want fairly short range, not very complex, infrared guided. Maybe one fuel tank, one thruster. So we're looking at about 500, 600. I'm not sure. Maybe we'll give it two fuel tanks, one thruster, one fin. So it's not particularly easy to maneuver, or maybe we'll build it slightly different, but it'll be either a 2 or 3 block missile. And that means that we're going to have tiered releases. So we'll have one down there, one up there, another up there, so on and so forth, all the way back. This is going to be a very, very heavily armed platform. I am going for maximum overkill with this system. This is going to be like one, maybe two at most per missile array structure. But to start with, let's get back down here, find the midpoint, which is right there. And once again, we will build our AI weapon controller without color. Not that it makes the blindest bit of difference really with this one. And then on the back, we want a wireless transmitter, wireless receiver. And we're going to want this one. Ooh, did I build one over there? Fairly certain I did, but I might have been incorrect. Did I not build it? I did not. Yes, I have worked that out. Okay, let's go back down here. Oh, I was lucky. But we would want to color this one then. Let's color that one in gold. And lock this in place. There we are. So there's... that would have been so embarrassing. We'll set this one up on channel 4, I think. So there we are. That's all set up. That would have really, really been a better time. I'd be like, why aren't these things firing? And it would have been my own stupid fault. But there we are. So this is going to be, I think this will be the primary weapon system of the missile setup. Now we're going to want to set this, it's not going to be 1000. It's flat out not going to be able to reach that far. We'll set it to 800 and we'll see where we go with that. We want this to also be set up as weapon system 1. And then we're going to want to start with the missile controller. There we go. We'll place that. We don't want it colored. We'll place it about there. This will be able to control both. We will then set this one up to one. There we go. Now, how this is going to hook up. I'm wondering if we should have this on staggered fire. If we do, we really don't want it on very much of a staggered fire. I could have the infrared sticky flares. I could put them on each rack if I really wanted to. That might be worth trying. And have a couple of them on each rack. Because each rack is going to have 15. So we'll have 15 missiles by two. So each level will have 15 missiles. So I could put like three. So one in the middle, one on either side. So that there's bound to be a sticky flare in the sky at any time. So we would want a laser designator on every single level. That might be interesting. So that would reduce this then to 14 missiles on the bottom level. But that's fine, honestly. Why am I on that one? I want to be on this one. There we go. So we'd want a primary laser designator right there, perhaps. Or I could stick it in the middle. Yeah, actually, I kind of like the idea of having it in the middle. That's three blocks there. So if I bring that back. Right, there we go. So drop down the mirror line. We want this to be branching out to about there. Then we'd have another. So that's where that three would start. We don't actually need to set it back by three on each. We could start the next one about here. So we've got one there. Yeah, I'll do that the same up here. And then finally. No, actually, I would like it set back a little bit more than that. So let's set this back about there. And then over here, we'd have one last one. Now, we might not have just three tiers. We could go all the way back and have four. My lord, that'd be a lot. That'd be 60 missiles. I did say I wanted overkill. Not sure I meant that much, but risk it for a biscuit. There we go. So that's all set up. Now we can set up the staggered fire, which we kind of want for this. So where are you? We want the definitely, absolutely, positively. We want, in fact, two of them because it's so important we don't actually. But let's get rid of that. We want these to be regular colored. So want one, identify friend or foe, and then another staggered fire add-on. And we want these to be fairly delayed. Wow, this system. It's probably going to be rearmed the bottom missiles by the time it's firing the last ones. Like Rourke's Drift. It's going to be fantastic. First row kneels down, second row stands up, etc., etc. Ah, wonderful. I might even call this the Zulu missile system. Let's see. We want the missile launch pad. Now, these are not going to have eject add-ons, and that is a bit of a shame. But I can't think of a good way of adding that into it. So we're just going to have to live with that one. I should add the mirror line back as well. Now the middle point would be here perhaps. Or maybe one further up. We'll have to see on that one. I wonder if having two laser designators would actually even help. I don't think it would, so I'm not going to worry about it too much. Egads, it's going to be crazy. I'm actually thinking that that is a little bit overkill. 60 missiles? And they're so far back. In fact, yeah, I think it's way too much. We'll do away with that. Plus, it's kind of nice to have the symmetry there, because we've actually got a middle then, which we won't have otherwise. Right, so we want this back to fleet main. We want to build this out to about here. About there will do, actually. We then want this, and we want a laser emitter. So we want this up like that. There we go. Now, I guess I could sacrifice the side missiles. Yeah, we may as well. I want it to look nice, damn it. This is going to be a crazy setup, so I may as well make it look nice. There we go. And then we want the 4 meter slope rotated this way. There we are. So that's my laser designator in the middle there. Oh my lord, this thing is going to be crazy. Right, next up is to build. This is going to take so much ammunition to load as well, which is the other thing. Is the missile torpedoes. We want the actual missile blocks, and we want them to be colored red for this. However, I could... Ooh, that's actually a very good idea. We'll have them as 3. I'm not going to have them as 4. We'll have the blocks, which are... Let's link their in position. To designate colored slightly differently. We'll have them colored golden. I actually really like that idea. And then 3 up there. In fact, with this system, I could have the upper levels with different types of missiles entirely, like longer range swarm missiles, but I'm not particularly taken by that idea, honestly. There we go. Quite possibly the most OP system I have made. By far. In fact, we could make the designator missiles a little bit more bulky. And then add one in there as well. There we go. So this is my swarm rack. Absolutely glorious. We've lost a little bit from it. So in total, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So we've got 30. And we've got 44. No, sorry. We've got 42 missiles in total. That is a reasonable swarm. In my humble opinion, I think that's pretty potent. So the way we're going to set this up, we're going to set all of these missiles to the same sort of thing. Let's have a look. We've got 2 fuel tanks, a fin, an explosive warhead, and an infrared... Where are we? Infrared seeker. So just an explosive warhead, a fin, 2 fuel tanks. It'll probably reach its destination at 800. In fact, with this, it'll probably reach 1,000. But we'll err on the side of caution. Now we're going to save that. Have we actually got something for 3 blocks? I don't think we have, so that's fine. We're going to be saving this as... I think it's just a swarm missile. We'll call this the B Mark 1. It travels in a swarm. There we go. Next, we're going to want to assign that to all of the missiles of that length. And next, we are going to want to set up the designators. So again, this one's a little bit better at moving. We're not... Right, we want laser designator receiver on these. We also want sticky flare. When in the air, it attracts infrared-seeking missiles, can stick to vehicles and make them prominent targets and attract more missiles to specific parts of the vehicle. So we want to add that there. And we will have the target position prediction guidance on this one. Simply to help it actually reach its destination, I think. I'm not sure if that's really going to be useful or not, but we'll have to see. And it sounds like my neighbors are doing some very odd things in the yard. I'm not sure if you're going to be able to hear that or not. It sounds like they're mowing, and also I think one of them's hitting their car. How bizarre. Hopefully my mic is not picking all of that up, but if it is, there's not a lot I can do about it. Right, so we've got a sticky flare, target precision, prediction, guidance, laser, designator, receiver. That is fine. We are going to save this as the Queen Mark 1. So, the bees are going to follow the Queen. That seems to make perfect sense to me. Look at that sticky flay. That's fantastic. I actually also need to make sure that this is assigned to all of the missiles of the same length. Okay. Now, before I actually set this whole thing up and finish building it and building out the backs and making it a proper, nice-looking thing, because right now it's just a black blob. Let's see if this actually works. So, there we go. Oh, Kuroro, I'm so sorry for this. I'm not even sure if there's anything I can say that'll make it up to you, but for science, maybe? Will that do? I hope so. Go forth, queens. Lead your army. Oh, this is brilliant. That's right. Are they not even getting there? So I'm only seeing the queens get there. And yet, I can't really afford to look back. No. They didn't. They didn't even remotely reach that destination. Okay. Well, that is going to need to be addressed. Scallywags. And welcome back after a brief fade there where I realized something very obvious. I decided to quickly build up the actual shell of the vehicle. We've already spent so long in this episode just building these two that I didn't think I'd have you hang around for me umming and ahhing over the design, but I actually think it looks quite nice. I've given it a bit of detail at the back, even though the back is, relatively speaking, fairly empty, like especially under here. There's not actually a lot going on in here. I could fill this out with other things, and I'll have a think on what that might be. Could I even store ammo barrels on the system? Shields are probably something I'm going to have to look at doing, but I actually quite like the aesthetic that I've got at the back there. It kind of looks like heat vents or like a heat sink sort of thing. But one obvious reason I should have totally keyed into this, but I've added a friend or foe system to the infrared, so they're not going to target friends even if the queens hit them. This is of course on my team, hence the color scheme. This is not, hence the not same color scheme. As you can see, this one got absolutely eaten. I will quickly demonstrate it for you just so that you can see what I did. Basically, I made it a deep water guard. I loaded in a Kuroro, has no weapons. So this isn't combat testing in the sense of survivability, just to see if I can get the weapons to actually do what they want to do. So I feel marginally better about that. Now, if I, I don't want to be building. I want to be controlling my character. Where is the system here? Just hop up on top of this. Ah, this looks very nice. I like it. Right, let's go to controlling this system. Zoom right in. And I've also tightened up the launch time. It now launches such that once it's finished unloading all of its ordnance, the upper missile rack is getting reloaded at the time. Now, if I just aim at the Kuroro about there and then stop controlling it. Oh, no. Okay, never mind. It doesn't want to aim that way. Fair enough then. Launch. Launch the missiles. All of them. Oh, look at that. This is what a swarm system should be. By the time the last one is launched, it's already reloading. And I can start again. Look at that. And it will actually launch these missiles. Like, the top is being reloaded as the bottom is reloading. So if I launch it straight away, it'll start firing the top rack and then just chase the reloading of the bottom rack. It's quite glorious. There we go. All of the missiles, please. All of the missiles, all of the time. And I can just keep this going. As long as I've got ammo, I can keep this up. So many missiles. I imagine most laser defense systems would have a hard time taking out this much ordnance. And we'll just wipe you out, I think. Maybe. Possibly. I'm really not sure how much use the queens are being, but I'm going to keep them there, just because I think it's kind of an epic idea, having designator missiles. But, yes. As you can see, significantly better when they're actually enemies. So that is going to be the end of this episode, I'm afraid. It has gone on much, much longer than expected. But, There we are. I'm going to be wrapping this episode up now. Suggestions for the names of these two weapon systems. Again, they will all be going onto a single structure, which will have its own AIs, its own engines, its own everything. I will also be adding on shield components off camera. You don't need to see me setting up shields, even though it's a bit of a potty task. That does actually take a little bit of time to get everything right. But they will probably be set up per station that I build, because it'll be highly dependent on the engine power built into that structure. So it won't actually be in the sub object itself. But yes, if you could supply me with suggested names for these two components, the swarm missile rack and the AA missile component, the last part will be a silo, and that's what we're going to be working on in the next episode. And then possibly, depending on how long that takes, we'll jump over to the campaign and actually start building all of this in the campaign. I cannot wait to see this weapon system actually start to attack things. Oh, it's going to be glorious. Or it's going to be hilariously ineffective and we're all going to die in a flaming ball of shenanigans. But that is all to be seen in the coming episode. So as always, I hope you've enjoyed this one and will be joining me for the next. But until then, do take care.